Welcome to this overview of the C. Bechstein Digital Grand. By playing your first notes, you'll notice the velocity histogram here at the bottom left. It gives you an instant feedback of how soft or hard your playing is. On the right, you'll see the visualization for each of the three fully supported pedal types, such as una corda, sostenuto, and of course, the hold or sustain pedal. The last one will support static on-off, and of course continuous controller data as well. The intensity knob for the una corda pedal allows you to control how much softer the sound will be. By the way, this effect was carefully measured with reference samples recorded for every single note. The volume knob to the right of the hold pedal controls the volume of the true sustain samples of our piano. We've sampled thousands of them at different velocities and applied in-depth mapping to match them to the original notes that were played without any use of the pedal. The five knobs at the top of the piano are shortcuts to their corresponding values on the other tabs we'll look at now. The String EQ tab is the invention of one of the most powerful note-defining tools ever seen in a piano plugin. To create it, we teamed up with our top-class piano technicians and tuners, and we spent hundreds of hours finding the right balance between flexibility of sound and staying faithful to the realism of the instrument, so that the character of the Bechstein piano is still retained even if you take these values to their extremes. So let's listen to what we can do here. First, a piece of music, as it sounds without any modification. Sounds good. Now let's add some gain to the bass frequencies for each of the mid-lower notes, to give the chords a bit more warmth. And I'd like to have a touch more presence for the melody, so let's add gain to the partials, but just for the notes C4 and above. No big difference, you might say. Well, let's turn it off again. Great, isn't it? That should be okay for now. We'll cover even more possibilities in another tutorial. Let's check the Audio Design tab. This screen has been designed with the sound engineer in mind. We recorded the front position of our piano with an MS microphone setting, so you have full control over both channels independently. In other words, with individual compression for the mid and the side signals. You have a pure 1960s mono-recorded grand piano if you like, and then make it as wide and as deep as you need to make it just right for your mix. This is, frankly speaking, awesome. So what's up with this greenish eye in the centre? Well, it blends the character of the digital grand towards a warmer pianissimo articulation when you move it down, or towards a more forte, more accentuated characteristic in the opposite direction. And this potentiometer will add another dimension to the sound. It's what we call the aura of the instrument, and it adds a subtle warmth to the recording. You can choose between an algorithmic or a more straight and natural version. It's up to you. But purge the needed extra memory with this button if you decide to keep the leaner version. So there's one more tab over here. The Details tab offers you access to a whole load of options to customize your sound and the feel of the instrument even more. At the top, control the volume and intensity of the key noises, the damper noises, and the pedals, and adjust the desired amount of the release portion of a note. This, by the way, depends dynamically on the velocity as well. Like you would expect from the real instrument, of course. Here, you have full control over the velocity to note mapping. Choose between different shapes and adjust the overall dynamic response, for instance, if you don't need a full range of feedback from the instrument for your practice. So what about these knobs here? Resonance color gives the pedal played samples even more life, and you can take it a bit over the top in case you need the kind of sound you'd expect from a typical digital piano. The sympathetic knob turns on the additional resonances that occur on the real instrument. You might know the trigger trick from a real piano. Gently hold down a key and trigger just its resonating overtones with a short note like this, say one octave up. So, that's the C. Bechstein Digital Grand, powered by Kontakt. We believe it's one of the most detailed sampled instruments available, and it will give you enormous flexibility whether you're an enthusiastic piano player, a music composer, or a professional sound engineer. Thank you for watching.